मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी स्टार्टेड विद कार्ड रेपर्टरी. इन दैट द कार्ड रेपर्टरीज दिस कंसेप्ट वॉज केम इन द माइंड ऑफ मेनी होम्योपैथ्स बिकॉज टू फाइंड आउट टू रेपर्टराइज द केस टू select the rubrics or to search the rubrics in the repertory, then proper repertorization to write down the markings in front of each medicine, then count those total number of marks that medicine is having, and then out of those we get the group of similimum. So this is a time consuming process. So many homeopaths, in the mind of many homeopaths, and also to use any repertory, there are many repertories and they are voluminous repertories. So to use those repertories, everyone should have thorough knowledge about the philosophy, about the construction of each repertory. Then only they can able to use those repertory. So how to find out the similimum in less efforts within a short time? Many in the mind of many homeopaths, the concept came that why not we should write down the rubrics on rubric on one page, and in front of that rubric we have to write down the number of the indicated medicines. And in this way many homeopaths, they started preparing their own diary or their own papers, and then in this way many papers, the bunch of papers, it get collected, and this is only called as the card repertory. Then we discuss in shortly how or when the repertories are get published, the where get published. The first Guernsey's Sleep, it get published. It was written by Dr. William Jefferson Guernsey, and it was published in 1892. As it was completed in 1888, but it was published in 1892. Then card repertory by Dr. Nunez was published in 1910, which is based on BTPB. Then Tyler's punched card repertory by Dr. Margaret Tyler was published in 1912. In 1913, Lewis punched card repertory by Dr. Welch and Houston. Then in 1922, card repertory by Dr. Field. In 1924, card index repertory by Dr. Cyrus Maxwell Boger. In 1948, card repertory by Dr. Marcos Jaminez. In 1948, card repertory by Dr. Busalian. In 1950, card repertory by Dr. J.G. Weiss. In 1950, spindle card repertory by Dr. R.H. Farley. In 1950, card repertory by Dr. W.W. Young and Dr. Pulford. In 1950, the modified Boger's card index repertory, which was completed by Dr. L.D. Dhaule, but it was not yet published, unfortunately. Then in 1950, P. Shankaran's card repertory, it was get published. In 1959, Dr. Jugal Kishore's homeopathic card repertory, it was get published. Then in 1984, Dr. Sharma's card repertory get published. In 1950, modified Bogart's card repertory. It was completed by Dr. L.D. Dahule, which was unpublished. In 1984, Dr. Sharma's card repertory, it was written by Dr. Shashi Mohan Sharma, and it was get published in 1984. Then, which are the essential qualities of good card repertory, which is also discussed in last lecture. Then we are discussing about the merits of the card repertory, that one has to select the cards according to rubrics arranged in repertorial totality and look for common remedies. Means first we have to do analysis, we have to do evaluation after taking the case. Then we make the totality of the patient, totality of symptoms. Then we convert that totality in the form of repertorial totality. And according to repertorial totality, according to the rubrics, we have to select the cards, arrange the cards, and then after arranging or selecting the cards, we have to look for the common remedies in those rubrics. This method, it saves time as compared to manual writing down. It cuts down time needed in calculation of marks and analysis. It does not require paperwork. So it save time, it save efforts, as well as it does not require paperwork. And the purpose is elimination of remedies in repertorial analysis. So these card repertories, it is also called as the mother of computer repertory, because from the card repertory, the concept to construct such computer repertory, it was born. So these card repertories, it is the mother of, it is also called as mother of computer repertories. So remember the merits, that in short time with less efforts, we can get the result of repertorization, or we can get the group of similimums. Then one has to select the cards according to repertorial totality, and with easily we can get the common remedies in all these repertorial totality. Then it does not require any paper, pen or paper work. So this method, these are the merits of the card repertory. Then which are the demerits of card repertory? It is difficult to include all remedies, as there are limitation of the space, because on one paper only we have to write down the rubric. So each indicated remedy for related rubric and sub-rubrics, we cannot able to include all the remedies many times, many rubrics or in many symptoms. It was difficult to include all remedies. Most of the card repertories do not represent the rubric well, especially sub-rubric. So as I told you that each rubrics are mentioned in card, but all the sub-rubrics, sub-sub-rubrics, it was not और मेनी टाइम्स इट वाज इम्पॉसिबल टू मेंशन ऑल द रूब्रिक्स सब रूब्रिक्स सब सब रूब्रिक्स विद देयर इंडिकेटेड मेडिसिन इन वन पेपर. इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू यूज फाइनर एक्सप्रेशन एट जनरल एंड पर्टिकुलर पर्टिकुलर लेवल्स इन रिपोर्टराइजेशन. सो इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू फाइंड आउट द रूब्रिक एंड सब रूब्रिक सब सब रूब्रिक्स विद देयर इंडिकेटेड मेडिसिन एवरी टाइम. कंप्यूटर रिपोर्टरीज हैव मेड इट obsolete. So in computer repertories we found all the rubrics, sub rubrics, sub sub rubrics with all their indicated medicines. But in the card repertory, on one card there is difficulty to write down everything, or difficulty under many rubrics the difficulties were faced by the authors to write down all the rubrics, sub rubrics, sub sub rubrics with their indicated remedies. So this is the main demerit of card repertories. Then Kishore's card repertory. So Dr. Jugal Kishore's homeopathic card repertory, this was the full name of Kishore's card repertory. The author was Dr. Jugal Kishore. There were three editions of this card repertory. The first edition get published in 1959. The second edition get published in 1967. And the third edition, which was published in 1986. This Jugal Kishore's card repertory, it is based mainly on Kane's repertory, but rubrics were taken from all the existing repertories. So the main base of this Jugal Kishore's card repertory was Kane's repertory, but the rubrics, many rubrics he has taken from the other existing repertories also. Then how this card repertory, this Jugal Kishore's card repertory, it was published, how it was planned and constructed. So this gigantic and very popular card repertory was published in 1959. As we know, the first edition, it was get published in 1959. Mainly it was based on Kane's work, though rubrics were taken from all the existing repertories of that time. In the first edition, there were 3,500 cards. In second edition was improved and contained about 10,000 cards and 600 medicine. And the third edition, it contained, it was published in 1986 and with few additions here and there. So in this way, In the first edition, there are less number of cards, that is, so in the first edition in 1959, there are 3,500 cards. In the second edition, which was published in 1967, there were addition of many cards as well as medicines in the second edition. About 10,000 cards get added and about 600 medicines it was get added. Then in the third edition it was get published in 1986, and in this third edition also there are additions of many medicines as well as cards also. This repertory was an attempt to substitute both Boningusen's as well as Kent's repertory. It can be used for cases with prominent mentals, physicals, or only particular symptoms. So in this Jugal Kishore's card repertory, as this repertory is based on Kent as well as Boningusen's repertory, so in this repertory we found the cards related to prominent mental symptom, prominent physical general symptom, as well as particular symptoms also we found in this repertory or in these cards. In Jugal Kishore's card repertory we found all symptoms related to mental general, physical general, as well as particular. This repertory comes in three wooden boxes with 10,000 cards. So any repertory, it come in wooden box. In our department also you can we have one card repertory, anytime you can see. And in the same way this Jugal Kishore's card repertory, it also come in three wooden box because there are large number of cards, about 10,000 cards in this Jugal Kishore's card repertory. So it comes in three wooden boxes. Box 1, which contains 4,000 cards, is from card number 1 to card number 3099. Box 2, which contains again 3,000 cards, which start from card number 4,000 up to card number 6099. And the box 3, it contain 3,000 cards, that means from card number 6,100 to 9,999. So in this way, in three different wooden boxes, this repertory we found. And the cards are separated. In the first box about 4,000 cards, in the second box about 3,000 cards, and in the third box about 3,000 cards we found there arranged. The cards, they have given the number so that it was easy to find out the cards. And there is list of remedies and their code numbers. So on the card, the remedies are given with code numbers. And with this card repertory, with these wooden boxes, they have given the list of remedies and their code numbers. In this repertory, in these cards, it contain about 591 medicines, and the serial number, it was given from 50 to 640. which starts from Abies canadensis to X-ray. So the alphabetically so it the list of remedies and their code numbers they have given. There are about 591 medicines in this repository, and it starts, it was, the list was arranged alphabetically. The serial numbers they have given or started from 50 up to 640. There are serial numbers, and they started from Abies canadensis to X-ray. So in this way, the list of the remedies, it was given with these boxes. So in this way, the list of the remedy, it was given. The name of the medicine, first they have given the code number for their for the medicine, and then they have written the name of the medicine. So this is the list of remedies with their code numbers with the card repository. How the cards, their structure. For example, if we want to search the rubric desire for company, then the desire for company, this rubric was given on the card 1933 number card. This rubric desire for company, it was given. And how the card was constructed. So the structure of card, each card has 80 vertical columns of number at the bottom as 1, 2, 3 up to 80 from left to right. So if you able to see, there are numbers have given from left to right. Each card has 80 vertical columns, and at the bottom the numbers have given from 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 80 from left to right. See, here the numbers have given from left to right. The numbers 1 to 80 also appear on the top at the second line. So on the top in the second line also the numbers are given. Above downwards each column contain about 0 to 9 numbers. So here the numbers you can able to see in the first column there are numbers given 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So in this way from above downwards each column contain about 0 to 9 numbers. Every card has a rubric written on the top of the card with the name of the chapter. See, in this card, you can able to see there is number of the rubric it was given and what is the rubric, that is desire for company, it was also given. So every card has a rubric written on the top of the card with the name of the chapter. Each rubric has a number written before the rubric. The number of the rubric is punched in first four columns, which is mean for indicating the rubric. Looking into these four columns, we can easily know the number of rubric by arranging the punch number from left to right. Then the card has rectangular punched areas here and there in the first edition. The punching were the shape of like this. So there is the cards. Here we cannot able to see exactly, but if you can see, then some small columns we can able to see. These are the punch which have done on the card. So they are rectangular punched areas on the card, which we can able to see with small white dots. If you see, there are small white rectangular pieces or areas we can found on the card. So these are nothing but the punched areas. And in the first edition, it was not rectangular, but its shape was like this. You know the code of medicine. We have to read the number always, putting the bottom number first in the left hand before the punch number. So to know the code of medicine, what is the code of medicine? We have to read the number always, putting the bottom number first in the left hand before the punch number. So before the punch number, there was at the bottom the number of medicine it was given, and from that number, with the help of the list of medicines with their numbers, we can able to find out what is the name of that medicine. The number is to be referred to the index to Kisho's card that reveals the name of the medicine. So the number is to be referred to the index to Kisho's card that reveal the name of the medicine. Then how we can reporterize the case by using Kisho's card repertory? The case is to be analyzed and repertorial totality is to be framed. First we have to do analysis, then we have to construct the repertorial totality. The symptoms are to be converted into rubrics. The final rubrics should be located separately, and the card number is to be written against each rubric. So first we have to construct the repertorial totality. Then we have to convert. First we have to make the totality. Then we have to convert the symptoms into rubric. Then the final rubric should be located separately, and the card number is to be written against each rubric. So after writing down the final rubric, we have to write down the card number which was written against each rubric. All the cards with rubrics should be kept in order against each rubric, against each other. Finally, the common punched hole is to be found holding them against light, and the medicine code is to be found out. So all the cards, after collecting the cards all the cards. There we have to keep all the cards in order, and finally we get the common punched hole, holding them against light. When we hold the cards in front, then we found some common punched hole. And what is the code of that punched hole? We have to collect that code number, medicine code, and then we have to find out the name of that medicine which is indicated. In this way, we get a group of medicines from the common punched hole, and by referring it to the index of Kisho's card. So in this way, only we have to select, we have to make the proper repertorial totality, then we have to select the cards, we have to convert the symptom into rubric, we have to select the cards according to the card number, then we collect or we arrange these cards according to their number, according to their chronology, and then when we arrange or when we collect these cards together, then we get some common punched hole, then we have to find out the medicine code of that punched hole, and then we get the name of medicine. So this is the way to find out the common medicine or the similima. In this way, we get a group of medicines from the common punched hole, and by referring it to the index of Kisho's card. These medicines are to be referred to the materia medica, and then to select the similimum of the particular case. So in this way, after getting with the help of the medicinal number, we get the name of medicine, and if there are 2-3 medicine, then these medicines we have to refer in our materia medica, and out of those medicine we can able to select the exact similimum. Sometimes it may happen that the common hole is not visible after keeping all cards together. So many times we cannot get the common hole. In that condition, the least important card with rubric should be removed one after another. So as we arranging our cards, we arrange the card according to the totality, and in totality we have to give the important rubrics, we have to write the important rubrics in the first, and then more important rubrics first, and then less important rubrics. So if we cannot get the hole visible, then in such condition, in such situation, we have to remove the card with less important, which is least important. Then also, if the hole is not visible, then one after another, till we cannot get the common punched hole, we have to remove the cards with the least important rubric. So in this way, we have to find out the medicines, indicated medicines. Then what is the advantage of Kisho's card repertoire? Third edition, which contain 591 medicines. Then there are, we all know, there are about 10,000 cards in this repository.